the kind of politics we have now, where the left is represented by this kind of Obama-Macron-style centrism, where you're both for the market and for bureaucracy at the same time, you know, is kind of horrible, right? The only possible appeal of that kind of politics is, well, at least they're not Nazis, right? So what they want is the left to be this kind of mishmash of bureaucratic market centrism and the right to be outright fascist. To set the ball rolling in an actual left direction will make that centrism look like utterly unappealing. In France, sometimes they talk about the extreme center, and I think that's a fitting phrase. It strikes me that what's called the moderates are the most immoderate people possible. And the reason why they're so uncompromising, I think, is because they realize they don't have a lot of positive arguments. They're not really for anything. I mean, somebody like Obama, the reason he worked was because he looked like the kind of guy who would have a vision. He acted like a visionary. He had the intonation. He had the way of standing and looking into the distance like he really believed in something. And it shows you something about just how much visionary politics has been killed. It didn't even seem to occur to people to ask what his vision actually was, right? Because it turns out, insofar as he had a vision, his vision was not to have a vision. You know, he believed in pragmatism and compromise and so forth. And that's what the center has been reduced to. It's become this pure set of performative symbols. And at the same time, you get to feel morally superior, which is ultimately what centrism, what liberal centrism is all about, is the ability to feel better than other people. So there is a kind of a symbiosis whereby the right wing pretend to be stupid, like George Bush II sort of perfected this, like I'll act like a yokel, all of the liberals will make fun of me as an idiot, everybody who resents the sort of cultural elite for having monopolized all the good jobs will look at them sneering at me and say, yeah, I bet those guys feel the same way about me as they feel about Bush, I'll vote for Bush, ha ha ha, stick it to him, right? You know, that shtick, Trump is just doing it in a more extreme version of the same thing, Johnson's doing the same thing. You know, you act like an idiot, the people who are the sort of educated elite make fun of you and it works. Now, who's really the idiot, right? People keep falling for the same stupid trick over and over and over again. There's a symbiotic relationship between these centrists who are just sort of sneering elitists and these guys who are the scam artists who pretend to be yokels, who pretend to be idiots, or pretend to be fascists. They're not even real fascists. They're kind of phony fascists. They are trying to set up a situation where those are the only two viable political choices because they both feed off and complement one another. If the last election in the UK showed anything, it's that the existing media is not our friend. We need to create media that will actually allow other voices to come out and to talk about what's really going on. Double Down News on Patreon is one of the ways that we are trying to create alternative media. This is something you can do to help.